Okay, good.
Very good. So give me a second. I'm also good. Wonderful. Enjoying the life to the fullest. चलिए, सो वी आर इन द सेकेंड लास्ट सेशन ऑफ द मनी एंड बैंकिंग। हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर कमिंग फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम टुडे? कितने लोग हो जो आज फर्स्ट टाइम आए हो? यू कैन राइट एम ई मी इफ यू आर कमिंग फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम टुडे। अगर आप फर्स्ट टाइम क्लास में आए हो तो आप एम ई मी लिख सकते हो। सो दिस इज द सेकेंड लास्ट सेशन ऑफ द मनी एंड बैंकिंग। ओके रेडमी, व्हाट इज योर गुड नेम? मिस्टर रेडमी तनु। ओके वंडरफुल, वेरी गुड। सो लेट मी टेल यू समथिंग अबाउट दिस सीरीज। दिस इज द सीरीज वेयर वी आर कवरिंग ऑल द करंट अफेयर सेशंस। वी आर इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर विच इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर। वी विल स्टार्ट पब्लिक फाइनेंस आफ्टर दिस एंड वी विल कवर ऑल द चैप्टर्स। वी विल कवर एग्रीकल्चर, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, इंडस्ट्री, ऑल दीज चैप्टर्स अलोंग विद द इकोनॉमिक सर्वे। सो आई विल कवर द इकोनॉमिक सर्वे ऑफ दीज चैप्टर्स ऑल्सो, राइट? द कवरेज ऑफ दिस सेशन इज फ्रॉम मे 19 टू अप्रैल 2020, राइट? इनफैक्ट आई एम ऑल्सो इनकॉर्पोरेटिंग द वेरी लेटेस्ट न्यूज। सून आई एम कमिंग विद दिस आत्मनिर्भरता अभियान विच हैज बीन लॉन्च बाय द गवर्नमेंट। सो आई विल ब्रिंग ए कंप्लीट सेशन ऑफ 1 आवर ऑन डिस्क लाइक डिस्कसिंग अबाउट ईच एंड एवरी टर्म देयर। देर आर सम ग्राउंड रूल्स अबाउट दिस क्लास। यू शुड पार्टिसिपेट इन द क्लास, शुड गिव द आंसर इन द चैट बॉक्स, शुड शेड्यूल योर सेल्फ फॉर डेली 10 AM। सो अर्लियर वी यूज टू हैव द क्लास एट 11 AM, नाउ वी विल हैव इट एट 10 AM। ठीक है, 10 AM इज अ गुड टाइम एंड इफ इफ यू एग्री देन आई कैन ऑल्सो प्रीपोन इट टू 9 AM सो दैट यू कैन स्टार्ट योर डे अर्ली। ठीक है, आप अपना दिन जल्दी स्टार्ट कर सको। यू शुड हैव ए नोटबुक एंड पेन, इट इज रिकमेंडेड एंड पीपीटी विल बी अपलोडेड इन द टेलीग्राम ग्रुप। इफ यू डोंट नो द टेलीग्राम ग्रुप, जस्ट गो टू द टेलीग्राम एंड सर्च एट द रेट IAS इकोनॉमी, यू विल फाइंड, राइट? We are having the live classes on a daily basis. So this is the current economy class. Apart from that, we are covering GS paper 2, GS paper 3 and mains current affairs. We are covering the strategy and issues also, right? We will also come up with the guidance sessions about the prelims, how to solve the prelims MCQ with examples. I will tell you. We will come up with the mains answer writing sessions, how to write the answers, right? And we will discuss the strategy of GS1. We will discuss the strategy of SA. All these things we will discuss. For those people who are planning for 2021, I will also bring one session for the 2021, right? Okay, good. Shivkami, you were not available yesterday. What happened? Everything good? चलिए, सो मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी रिलेटेड डेवलपमेंट्स वी कवर्ड इन द फर्स्ट टू सेशंस। पहले जो दो सेशन थे हमने ये सब कवर किया। दीज आर ऑलरेडी ऑन द यूट्यूब। रेस्ट ऑफ द सेशंस आई विल अपलोड ऑन द यूट्यूब वेरी वेरी सून एंड आई विल अपलोड ए प्ले लिस्ट इन द यूट्यूब इन द टेलीग्राम चैनल। ठीक है, तो यूट्यूब में अपलोड करके एक प्ले लिस्ट बना दूंगा सो दैट यू कैन रिवाइज एंड यू कैन रेफर टू योर फ्रेंड्स ऑल्सो। वी हैव कवर्ड ऑल दीज थिंग्स, बेसल लॉम्स, NPA, राइट? We have covered all these things, and today this session is very, very important because we are going to discuss all these terms and many more terms about the electronic banking system. So today's session is going to be very, very important. Very, very important, right? The questions are coming from these type of areas. That is why I have taken this topic today, right? So today's question is here in front of you. Please give the answer to this question, and then we will discuss about this.
So you have another 10 seconds to give the answer. Please give the answer in the chat box. Everyone, please participate. Okay, good. Keep giving the answer, please. Answer dete raho. Please, everyone, participate. I can see most of you are giving the right answer. Very good. Okay, so answer to this question is option C. आंसर है इसका ऑप्शन सी, राइट. नेशनल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक फंड ट्रांसफर इज ए नेशन वाइड पेमेंट सिस्टम फैसिलिटेटिंग वन टू वन फंड ट्रांसफर, राइट. एंड वन वे ट्रांसमिशन फ्रॉम इंडिया टू नेपाल इज पॉसिबल, राइट. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट डिस्कशन अबाउट द बेसिक्स ऑफ द एनईएफटी एंड द आरटीजीएस, राइट. सो दीज आर द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक फंड ट्रांसफर सिस्टम्स which were used in India. Let us see basics about these, because this NEFT has been in news because earlier this NEFT was applicable only during the working days. Pehle aap NEFT ko sirf working days mein hi use kar sakte the. Now you can use this NEFT even during the non-working days, that is on the public holiday, Saturday, Sunday, right? So because of this, this NEFT has been in news. इसकी वजह से NEFT news में है, ठीक है? So let us see what is the NEFT. NEFT is a electronic fund transfer system. The name itself says national EFT. EFT means electronic fund transfer. The transfer of fund through the electronic means. And it is maintained by the Reserve Bank of India. Please keep in mind, this is maintained by the Reserve Bank of India. We will discuss many other systems today. Aaj hum bahut sare system padhne wale hain. Many of those systems are maintained by the NPCI, National Payment Corporation of India. But NEFT, it is maintained by the Reserve Bank of India. Ye Reserve Bank of India maintain karta hai. Theek hai? This system was started in November 2005. And it enables the bank customers in India to transfer fund between any two NEFT enabled bank account on a one-to-one basis. So what is the meaning of one-to-one basis? Suppose here is Mr. A, here is Mr. B. Mr. A transfers rupees 1 lakh to Mr. B. Suppose this transfer is made at 10 a.m. So this amount will be transferred to Mr. B's account, and in Mr. B's account this will be reflected at least after half an hour, that is at 10:30 a.m. right? And this transfer will be one to one. That means this suppose there are various other transaction also. Bahut sare aur bhi transaction ho sakte hain. Mr. A ka hai, X ka hai, Y ka hai, Z ka hai. Bahut sare other transfers hain. Theek hai? So lot of other transfers are being made to many other people, right? There is a series of transactions. This transaction will not be clubbed with those transactions. Ye transaction unke saath mein club nahi hoga. This will be going one to one only. Ye one to one hi jayega. Theek hai? So this is the speciality of the NEFT. Ye NEFT ki speciality hai. Now, if we talk about RTGS, real time gross transfer. Theek hai? Real time gross transfer. Now, what is the real time gross transfer? In this case, suppose Mr. A sends rupees 1 lakh at 10 a.m. This 1 lakh rupees will be received by Mr. B at 10 a.m. only. That is at the real time. So just like this class is happening in the real time, I am speaking from this side, you are hearing from that side. Similarly, you click
the payment button here, and in the like Mr. A will click the payment button. The amount will be deducted from Mr. A's account. Amount will be credited in Mr. B's account immediately. No time lag. Koi time lag nahi hoga. Immediately paisa transfer ho jayega. Theek hai? So this is real time gross transfer. Right? Theek hai? So real time ka matlab ho gaya? Immediately. The second word is gross. So one thing is real time. Another is gross. What is the meaning of gross? Gross means it is clubbed with it can be clubbed with various other transactions. Ye bahut sare other transactions saath mein club ho sakta hai, but ultimately it reaches real time. Theek hai, koi waiting period nahi hai. There is no waiting period. And apart from that, there is also one more difference. In case of NEFT, the minimum transaction amount is rupees 1 only. Aap 1 rupee bhi send kar sakte ho, but this RTGS is applicable only for big size transactions, that is minimum 2 lakh rupees you have to send. Theek hai, to RTGS sirf aur sirf bade transactions ke liye hi applicable. It is applicable only for those transactions which are having the minimum value of rupees 2 lakh. Theek hai, to minimum 2 lakh rupees ki value ke liye RTGS applicable hai. Now there is one more system, that is the IMPS. Ek aur system hai jisko hum bolte hain IMPS. So I hope most of you use this system. मैं तो बहुत ज्यादा यूज करता हूँ इसको. आई यूज दिस सिस्टम अ लॉट. राइट, दिस इज वेरी वेरी लाइक इजी टू यूज. ठीक है, सो नाउ व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द एनईएफटी एंड द आईएमपीएस. तो इन केस ऑफ एनईएफटी द अमाउंट इज क्रेडिटेड इन द बैचेस. बैचेस का मतलब हो गया, फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई टोल्ड यू मिस्टर ए मिस्टर बी. मिस्टर ए ट्रांसफर्ड द अमाउंट एट 10 AM. मिस्टर बी विल रिसीव द अमाउंट एट 10:30 AM. राइट, सो this batch of half an hour is there. ये half an hour का batch है. This amount will be transferred only in these batches of half an hour. Every half an hour the amount will be transferred for all the transactions which have been made in the last half an hour. ठीक है. Secondly, NEFT in this case there is no charge from July 1, 2019. So if you transfer any amount with the help of NEFT, you are not supposed to pay any amount. आपको कोई payment नहीं करनी है. This is completely free of cost. ये पूरी तरह से free of cost है. And NEFT can also be done offline by visiting the branch. So if Mr. A is the customer, Mr. A can go to the bank branch, suppose State Bank of India in Connaught Place, New Delhi. So this is a branch, bank branch in which he is having the account. He can go to this bank account, bank, and submit a form. एक फॉर्म सबमिट करेगा वेयर ही विल फिल द डिटेल्स ऑफ द रिसीवर. जो रिसीवर है उसका बैंक अकाउंट रिसीव बैंक अकाउंट नेम आईएफएससी कोड ऑल दोस थिंग्स विल बी फिल्ड इन दिस फॉर्म एंड मिस्टर ए विल साइन दिस फॉर्म एंड विल सबमिट टू द बैंक ऑफिसर. सो दिस ट्रांजेक्शन कैन बी डन ऑफलाइन. दैट मीन्स मिस्टर ए कैन सबमिट द रिक्वेस्ट इन द हार्ड कॉपी टू द बैंक एंड बैंक विल इनिशिएट द ट्रांजेक्शन फ्रॉम इट्स साइड and the amount will reach to the Mr. B. ठीक है, तो offline does not mean the cash. Offline means not through the net banking but through the bank branch ke through hoga, net banking ke through nahi hoga. Right, so this is the meaning of offline. Right, but in case of IMPS, if we talk about IMPS, the transaction is possible only through online. Aapko sirf aur sirf online hi ho sakta hai. The facility to transfer this amount with the help of bank branch, that is not available. You can use this facility only through the net banking. Aap sirf aur sirf net banking se hi is facility ko use kar sakte ho. IMPS is available in real time, right? So immediate payment service system. Immediate, right? Immediate means real time only. Sirf aur sirf immediate hai ye, real time hai. Theek hai? In this case, some bank charges may be applicable for certain big amounts. अगर आपका amount ज़्यादा है, तो आपका bank charge applicable हो सकता है. In case of NEFT, there is no upper limit, right? There is no upper limit. You can transfer 2 lakh rupees, 4 lakh rupees, 10 lakh rupees. But in case of IMPS, there is a upper limit of maximum 2 lakh rupees per day. In single day, you can transfer how much? Maximum rupees 2 lakh rupees. ठीक है? So is the difference between NEFT, IMPS, RTGS clear? You should know these small things, because nowadays UPSC is asking these type of question, right? And if you are appearing in any other examination, then also this becomes very, very important. Apart from that, for your day-to-day life also, this is very, very important. Aapki day-to-day life may be practical application iski hai. This has a very practical application. So this is very, very important. Now, the difference between the NEFT, RTGS and IMPS. So you can see in this macro view, minimum transfer in case of NEFT is rupees 1. In case of RTGS, the minimum transfer is rupees 2 lakh. So this is RTGS is only for the big size transactions. Ye big size transactions ke liye. IMPS is for the minimum rupee 1. So before I move ahead, I would like to ask from you, how many of you are using the mobile phone for watching this lecture? So if you are watching the lecture on the mobile phone, then I will recommend one thing, that you should keep your phone in the horizontal manner. Aap apne phone ko horizontal mein rakho, theek hai? So that you can see this screen sharing in the 100% window. Aap apni screen ko puri tarah se dekh sako. If you keep like that, agar aap is tarah se rakhte ho, so can you see the screen is not 100%, it is occupying only 30% of the screen area. Agar aap horizontal mein rakhte ho, to 100% aata hai. If you keep like that, you will see 100% PPT, like your complete screen is occupied, pura fit ho gaya. Aur agar aap aise rakhoge, to aapki screen mein bahut chota sa dikhega. So keep like that. Theek hai? And I recommend, my personal recommendation is, you should use the laptop. Aapko laptop use karna chahiye, so that you can have a much more better view. Theek hai? Okay. Great. And I will recommend one more thing, that those people who have named themselves with some other code, for example, there is 3A7296. So those people should rename themselves. Unko apna naam ko, please write your correct name. Be proud of yourself, right? So that will help me pointing it out to you. ठीक है, मैं कुछ भी आपसे बोलना चाहूँगा तो मैं बोल सकता हूँ. So there will be easy communication. ठीक है, तो चेतन है and there are some other people who have not used their correct name. So you should always use your correct name. So you can take few second and you can rename yourself. Right? आप अपने आप को rename कर सकते हो. ठीक है, so that will be helpful in better communication. वो better communication मैं उससे कर पाऊँगा. ठीक है. The question of Preet is, sir, is RTGS possible in both method online and offline only? Okay, so RTGS, yes, it is possible both online and offline. You can go to the bank branch and you can submit the request and bank branch will be transferring the amount from your account to the receiver on a real-time basis. Okay, so yeah, online and offline dono possible hai. NEFT and RTGS, both are possible. Both online and offline, but IMPS, this is possible only and only through the online mode. ठीक है, IMPS only through the online mode. Maximum value in case of NEFT and RTGS, there is no limit, there is no upper limit. ठीक है, but in case of IMPS, this is meant for the small transactions, so there is a upper limit of 2 lakh rupees. Settlement type in case of NEFT on every half an hour. And here in these two cases on a real time basis, NEFT, it is working 24/7. Ye 24/7 all the days available hai. This is the change which has happened recently. Ye change abhi hua hai, that is why this NEFT is in news. NEFT news mein isliye hai kyunki ye 24/7 is available right now. Earlier it was also available only during working hours and only on the working days. Pehle ye sirf aur sirf working days mein aur working hours mein available tha. Now it is available on all the days and on all the hours. 24/7 is this NEFT. This is the news. This is a very, very important point. Because of this only, this NEFT is in news, and because of this only, we are learning this topic as of now. NEFT, there is no charge. There are no inward charges, right? RTGS, there are no charges. Koi charges nahi hai. Koi transaction, inward transaction charges nahi hai. But in case of IMPS, the amount can be identified by the individual banker. So you can see this NEFT, this is there for round the clock transactions. /24 NEFT system is available on all the days of the year, including the holidays, right? So now this is 24/7 NEFT, 24/7. Earlier it was applicable only on the working days. It was only on the weekdays, 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. right? There is no upper limit. This is important. So we have one agreement with the Nepal. We have an agreement with the Nepal where one way, that is from India to Nepal only, not vice versa. One way cross-border transfer. One way, that is India to Nepal, this cross-border transfer is possible. Okay? And this amount is credited only in the batches. Batches ka matlab ho gaya? Every half an hour, all the transactions which were completed during last half an hour, those transactions will be completed. Shivam is asking how to do NEFT in public holidays by offline method. Yes, definitely. So it is not possible in the public holiday. It is not possible, right? It is possible only and only online. It is very common sense. Sir, NEFT Polymy is asking, sir, NEFT transfers only between India and Nepal or other countries too? Only India and Nepal. So we have signed an agreement with the Nepal. So the transfer is made only to the Nepal. Will you cover 1 year current affair? My friend, what is your good name? 3A72906C. It is your code name. I hope you are not a intelligence person. So you can reveal your name. No harm in that. Amit Aman. Okay, great. So yes, 1 year current affair will be covered. It is being covered 100%. No doubt about it. Chaliye. So the answer to the question is both option 1 and 2, that is option C, statement 1 and 2, option C. Now please answer this question. Yes, Polymy, RTGS IMPS not possible for cross border. Yes, you are right. Please answer this question in the chat box and give the answer to me privately. Don't give the answer in the everyone, right? So when you type anything in the chat box, you will have two options, either to ping me, it is a IAS preparation. You will find option to ping either IAS preparation or everyone. So you should ping to me. Don't ping to everyone, because then other people will be disturbed. Surajit, you were not available yesterday. What happened? Everything right? Were you available? I think you were not available yesterday. Shreya, you were not available yesterday. Shivkami, you were not available yesterday. What happened? Everyone, please answer. Okay, Surajit. Okay, you are available. Okay, everyone, please keep giving the answer. Everyone, please keep giving the answer. If you don't know, you can write and or no, so that I understand that you are interacting with me. You are available in the class. Okay, Shivkami, please take care. So now we have preponed the time from 11 a.m. to 10 a.m. The answer to this question is option D, that is only 2 and 3, right? One is wrong because this is not the initiative of Bank Board Bureau. This is not the initiative of Bank Board Bureau. This is an initiative of RBI and Indian Bankers Association. It is a not-for-profit company, and NETC is developed by NPCI. This is correct. Okay. So answer to this question is option D, that is 2 and 3 only. Okay. Would you please share your NCERT notes for free? Which NCERT? Okay, great. Next question is this one. Please read carefully. So Tanu, I am sharing many resources free of cost. Current affairs economy, current affairs government scheme, current affairs polity. But these correct notes are not available free of cost. You can buy. They are available at very reasonable cost. Everyone, please give the answer. Very, very important question. So I can't see answers of many people. Please give the answer. Amit Aman, your answer is not available. Ashish, Dev, Veena, Tanu, Supriya. Okay, Supriya has given the answer. Shivkami, your answer is not available. Okay, you have given the answer. Devanshi has also given. Asus, who is Mr. Asus? Please give the answer. Chaliye, very good. The answer to this question is option B, 1 and 3 only, right? So yes, RuPay is the first of its kind domestic means made in India debit and credit card. Okay, so please keep in mind this is giving both debit and credit card, right? It is not only debit but credit also. Okay, credit bhi hai, right? It is a payment network, right? So just like there is MasterCard, Visa card, right? Similarly, we have this RuPay card. This is the product of not NSDL, but this is the product of NPCI, National Payment Corporation of India, right? We will discuss more about it in the upcoming slide. And RuPay ATM come debit card holder, only debit card holder, not the credit card holder. They are eligible for accidental death and permanent disability insurance cover, right? So insurance cover is available to them. So option B, both 1 and 3 is the right answer. Next question. So we will discuss each one of them. Okay, hum log sab kuch discuss karenge. NPCI we will be discuss, We will discuss RuPay card, FASTag. We will discuss in detail because these things are very, very important nowadays. Yes, Shubhajit, above 70 years, they are not available. These are the, like, those are the terms and condition. But the point here is it is available on all kinds of debit card. Sabhi tarah ke debit card pe applicable hai. Yes, definitely there will be some terms and conditions, right? Kuch terms and conditions to hoti hi hain. We have to see whether it is applicable on the card or not. Don't see the card holder. The card holder kaun hai? See the card. Theek hai. Okay, Ramashis. Good. Okay, Ramashis, I got it. Good. So please give the answer. I can't see much answers. Please give the answer. It's for you people only. These type of questions are being asked in the UPSC prelims examination and other examinations also. So this is important for all the examinations. Please give the answer. Everyone keep giving the answer, participate, interact, take advantage of these sessions. Very important question, and most of you are giving the wrong answer. Most of you, not everyone, but most of you giving the wrong answer. That means this topic needs some discussion. So how many of you are really uncertain about the preparation? Examination is not sure, date is not sure. Railway has cancelled the ticket till 30th June. That means examination will go in July, August. How many of you are not sure about what, like, not like really disturbed in your preparation? You are not able to manage the discipline. If you are in that category, then I'm starting a very beautiful series daily at 9 p.m. I will be giving you the target of next day, and I will be asking you the questions of the day, like whatever target I have given, I will ask you the questions from that day's target. So that will bring discipline in your studies. I will give you the target both for the prelims and mains, right? So I will be asking the questions from the prelims point of view. In the morning session, I will be teaching you. So like this current affairs prelims, some topics of GS2, some topic of GS3, like that. It's like small things. Yeah, I will give a routine. I am thinking that I can give you some routine where you can complete the entire prelims in the next 2 months. Assuming that prelims will happen on 31st of July. Assuming that prelims will happen on 31st of July, I can give you some schedule, right? Main aapko schedule de sakta hun. And those people who are weak in the economy, I have a very, very beautiful course for you. This course is covering all everything, like entire static portion, very beautiful notes. Bahut hi acche notes hain. And the cost of this notes is, this class is only 1500 rupees, right? This is a full fledged class. The worth of this class is 10,000 rupees, but I have made available only for you at 1500 rupees, right? So those of you who are weak in economy, you can cover entire economy with very beautifully crafted PDF notes. Bahut hi acche notes hain, theek hai? And you will get these color coded notes, everything in that initiative. So this is available at a very low price, so that it can reach to maximum number of people, especially if you are from engineering and non-economic background. You should buy this session, this course. The recorded lectures are available, and you can start watching the lectures. Everything like will be become crystal clear. I have discussed previous year question, a static portion, relevant current issues, right? So you should really participate, and you can join this course by paying a very very small amount, right? Chaliye. So let us start with the NPCI, National Payment Corporation of India, right? So this is one of the very important organization which has actually transformed, the digital landscape of India, like especially the digital payment. Okay, so digital payment se sambandhit maximum initiative have been taken by this NPCI. Theek hai, NPCI ne ye maximum initiatives liye hain. So this is an umbrella organization for all the retail payments. So the name of this organization itself, it says National Payments Corporation of India. So it is about the payments, and which payment? Retail payment. So it is for the small payment. The choti choti payment hoti hai uske liye hota hai, theek hai? Now who is the founder? So it was set up with the support and guidance of RBI, that is the central bank, and Indian Banks Association and RBI, and this was set up under the Payment and Settlement Act 2007. Now, what is the legal existence? Is it a company? Is it a like society, trust, NGO? What? So it is a not for profit company. So this is a company, but for not for profit under the Section 8 of the Companies Act, and it includes 10 promoter banks. So promoter 10 hai. Right, promoter means those banks which started this initiative, jo jin logon ne start kiya, theek hai, they are the promoter banks. So you can see lot of initiatives. So these are the promoter banks, right? Lot of initiatives have been started by the NPCI. This National Financial Switch, ATM Network, CTS, ACH, APS, IMPS, cards scheme like RuPay, right? So we will discuss these and various other things in the upcoming slides. Abhi hum wohi cheez discuss karne wale hain. The purpose of NPCI is electronification of payments, interoperability. Interoperability means there is a seamless integration between banks, mobile devices or laptop devices, any kind of device, various billing agencies, various customer models, maybe in the form of QR code, or maybe in the form of smart card like debit card, payment card, credit card, or maybe in the form of you have the machines, other enabled payment system. So there is interoperability across the payment receivers, and across the devices, across the technologies, across the payment systems, and all that, right? So you can see lot many other initiatives. So we will discuss many of them. Hum bahut jaldi in sab cheezon ko discuss karne wale hain. this 99 QR code, standard interface of the mobile application, right? APBS, IMPS, AEPS, RuPay, e-commerce, NFS. We will discuss many of them. So let us start with the RuPay card. ठीक है? तो हम लोग RuPay card से शुरू करते हैं. So RuPay card, what is RuPay card? RuPay card is first domestic debit and credit card payment network of India. So ये हमारा खुद का बनाया हुआ है. And it has both debit and credit. So many of you might thought that this is only for the debit, but no, it is also for the credit. So in case of RuPay Jandhan Yojana, in case of Pranamanti Jandhan Yojana, we usually find this RuPay card is part of the Jandhan Yojana. RuPay debit card is a part. So that is why we think that this is only and only a debit card, but RuPay is also a credit card. It can also be a credit card. Okay. So you can see this RuPay card has some insurance facility also. So RuPay is offering complimentary personal accidental insurance and permanent total disability cover for all the RuPay card variants. So all kind of RuPay debit card, only for the debit card, right? All kind of RuPay debit card are getting the facility of insurance. Right, 2 lakh rupees in case of platinum card and 1 lakh rupees in case of classic card. You are not supposed to remember like what is the meaning of platinum card, you are not what is the meaning of classic card, but yes, these are the different limits. This RuPay insurance is available only if the card holder is having the age between the 5 years to 70 years. Theek hai, tabhi ye available hai. But it is available across the category for all kind of debit cards. Ye sabhi tarah ke debit cards ke liye applicable hai. The next initiative of the NPCI. So my friends, please understand them very very carefully. Inko bahut acche se samjho. The next initiative by the NPCI is National Common Mobility Card. Right. So this card will actually make it possible for traveling across the various modes of transportation. So you can use this card, you can travel in the metro, you can travel in the state transportation system, you can use this card for making the railway payment to the IRCTC and various other modes. So this card is the mobility card. Ye ek mobility card hai. This is the contactless card. That means you are not supposed to swipe this card. You can show from the distance and still the money will be deducted from your account, right? So this is the mobility card and this is a RuPay card only, RuPay debit card only, a prepaid card, right? You pay like you suppose, for example, you might be aware about the Metro card. Aapne Metro card ka naam suna hoga. To Metro ka jab hum card lete hain, we buy this card. And we recharge this card, suppose by rupees 500 rupees. So similar to that only, this RuPay debit and prepaid card is available. Okay. So my friends, please notice the small, small things which I'm telling you, because in the examination, they will be asking small, small things. So whether this mobility card is issued by the RuPay, is this a prepaid card or not? These small, small things can be asked in the examination, right? The next service by the NPCI. So, abhi tak humne kya kya padha? Till now, we have covered RuPay card. We have covered mobility card. The third service given by the UPI is the 99 USSD, right? What is the meaning of USSD? It means unstructured supplementary service data channel. Theek hai? Unstructured supplementary service data channel. And this is for UPI mobile banking. Ye UPI mobile banking ke liye hai. So in this case, what happens? Aap dekh sakte ho, this is a mobile. In the mobile, you just dial this number. Aap jab is number ko dial karoge, when you dial this number in your phone book, अब जब आप अपना मोबाइल खोल के उसमें डायल करोगे, यू विल हैव डिफरेंट ऑप्शंस, लाइक यू कैन यू डू यू वांट टू सेंड द मनी और डू यू वांट टू रिक्वेस्ट द रिसीट ऑफ मनी, यू वांट टू चेक द बैलेंस, व्हाट इज योर प्रोफाइल, पेंडिंग रिक्वेस्ट, ट्रांजेक्शन, यूपीआई पिन, ऑल दोज थिंग्स, राइट? सो इन दिस केस हाउ डू यू यूज दिस सर्विस, देर आर सम स्टेप्स. You can link your mobile number to the bank account, right? So in the bank account, wherever you have the bank account, you will link that bank account with your mobile number first. So in the record of bank, in the record of your bank, that number should be registered, right? After that, you will dial this number from your phone. In the first three letter, fill in the first three letter of your bank against short name or first four letter of IFSC, right? So there are some like these steps. So aap in step ko use karke, by using this step, you can transfer the money to any other bank account if you have some kind of MMID. ठीक है? तो जो pay का mobile number है और एक MMID होता है, there is some ID. This is some ID which will be given by the receiver of the payment. So you can use the mobile number of that person and MMID, you can enter the amount and your own mobile pin and leave a space and enter the last four digit of your account number. By this way you can transfer the money from your phone. Agar aapke paas mein simple phone hota hai na, if you have simple, very very simple phone, that is like Samsung Guru, aapne Samsung Guru suna hoga, mere paas bhi hai wo, abhi main yahan pe table pe nahi hai, to aap usse bhi transfer kar sakte ho. You are not supposed to have स्मार्टफोन, आपके पास में स्मार्टफोन की भी जरूरत नहीं है. सो दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी सिंपल सर्विस, वेरी वेरी सिंपल सर्विस, राइट? सो मेनी पीपल यूज दिस फॉर चेकिंग द प्रीपेड बैलेंस. आप अपना प्रीपेड बैलेंस चेक कर सकते हो, ठीक है? तो स्मॉल स्मॉल चीजें आप इसमें कर सकते हो, राइट? द नेक्स्ट सिस्टम इज आधार एनेबल्ड पेमेंट सिस्टम, ठीक है, जिसको हम बोलते हैं आधार पे. तो आधार एनेबल्ड पेमेंट सिस्टम क्या होता है? सो बेसिकली Under this, you can use this AEPS. This is a machine. You can see this machine. ये machine होती है, ठीक है? इस तरह की machine होती है. आप इस machine को use कर सकते हो for making the payment online. आप immediate payment करने के लिए आधार enabled payment system में इस machine को use कर सकते हो, ठीक है? So some banking correspondent, business correspondent और माइक्रो एटीएम, दे हैव दिस मशीन. कोई भी आपके पड़ोस में, जो भी रिमोट एरिया होते हैं वहां पर क्या होता है कि आपके पड़ोस में इन योर नेबरहुड देयर विल बी सम बिजनेस कोरेस्पोंडेंट और बैंकिंग कोरेस्पोंडेंट और सम माइक्रो एटीएम, दे विल बी हैविंग दिस मशीन, राइट? सो यू गो देयर, यू प्रोवाइड योर बैंक नेम, आप अपना बैंक का नाम बताओ एंड यू प्रोवाइड योर आधार नंबर. यू चूज द काइंड ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन यू वॉन्ट टू डू, लाइक यू वॉन्ट टू सेंड द मनी or you want to receive the money or you want to like deposit the money or you want to check the balance and you will provide the fingerprint on the scanner. ठीक है, तो जो आपके आधार वाले fingerprint है वो आप उसमें show करोगे and on successful transaction you can take a print slip and the transaction is completed. So this Aadhaar enabled payment system is very very useful for low value transactions in the remote areas. So remote areas mein ye bahut hi important hai. So what kind of service you can use from this machine? So is tarah ki machine bhi hote hain. Here this is basically to give your thumb. Ye aapka thumb impression dene ke liye hota hai. Theek hai? So it is your thumb scanner kind of. Theek hai? Your fingerprint verification, right? So you can deposit the cash in this micro ATM or with the business correspondent. You can withdraw the cash. You can do the balance inquiry or you can transfer the money to some other person through this service, right? So this is the Aadhaar enabled payment system. So my friends, are you getting the point? I am trying to simplify as much as possible. Meri koshish hai ki main aapki ye jo payment system hai ye inko simplify kar sakun. That is why I am showing you the picture also, right? So are you getting my friends? My friends, I am telling you, main aapko bata raha hu. In the examination, you will find small, small things. They can ask, can we deposit the money through Aadhaar enabled payment system? ठीक है, तो यहाँ पर नाम क्या है? Payment system है. सो इफ दे आस्क द क्वेश्चन, अगर वो क्वेश्चन पूछते हैं कि कैन वी डिपोजिट द मनी इन द आधार एनेबल्ड पेमेंट सिस्टम, यू माइट थिंक दिस इज अ पेमेंट सिस्टम, हाउ कैन वी डिपोजिट द मनी, बट द फैक्ट इज दैट वी कैन डिपोजिट द मनी, हम मनी भी डिपोजिट कर सकते हैं. सो यू शुड नॉट गो बाय द नेम ऑफ द सिस्टम, यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड द इंटरनल फीचर्स. ठीक है, तो जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल रुपए के लिए हमने पढ़ा कि रुपए इज अवेलेबल फॉर बोथ क्रेडिट कार्ड एंड डेबिट कार्ड. सिमिलरली हमने पढ़ा कि रुपए फैसिलिटी, दिस एनईएफटी फैसिलिटी इज अवेलेबल टू द नेपाल बॉर्डर ऑल्सो, नेपाल कंट्री के लिए वन वे क्रॉस बॉर्डर फॉर द नेपाल. सिमिलरली दिस आधार एनेबल्ड पेमेंट सिस्टम अंडर दिस द फैसिलिटी ऑफ कैश डिपोजिट इज ऑल्सो अवेलेबल. सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस स्मॉल पॉइंट, ऑल्दो दिस इज द पेमेंट सिस्टम द प्राइमरी पर्पस इज टू लाइक रिसीव द पेमेंट और डू द पेमेंट, बट इवन द कैश डिपोजिट इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल, कैश डिपोजिट भी इस सिस्टम के थ्रू पॉसिबल है. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस थिंग वेरी वेरी केयरफुली. ठीक है, इज द कैश डिपोजिट पॉसिबल विद द हेल्प ऑफ यूएसएसडी? नो, विद द हेल्प ऑफ यूएसएसडी द कैश डिपोजिट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. ठीक है, कैन वी विड्रॉ द मनी थ्रू आधार पेमेंट? यस डेफिनेटली, बिल्कुल विड्रॉ कर सकते हैं. सो दिस आधार एनेबल्ड पेमेंट सिस्टम इज कैप्ड बाय सम बिजनेस कोरेस्पोंडेंट, कोई बिजनेस कोरेस्पोंडेंट होता है हु इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग सम बैंक ब्रांच. ठीक है, हु इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग सम बैंक ब्रांच, सो यू गो टू दैट पर्सन एंड ही और शी विल सपोर्ट यू इन विदड्रॉइंग द पेमेंट. ठीक है, सो कैश विड्रॉल, यू कैन सी द सेकंड पॉइंट, द कैश विड्रॉल इज द इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर ऑफ द आधार एनेबल्ड पेमेंट सिस्टम. इज दैट क्लियर सुप्रिया? ओके ग्रेट. Rafiq, your question, how to join? So I will give you the link of this course in the chat box after some time. Chaliye. National Financial Switch. This is the next service. ठीक है, तो अभी तक हमने कितने सिस्टम पढ़े हैं? We have covered. So why I am revising? मैं इसलिए revise कर रहा हूं. So that you understand that all these are the services rendered by the NPCI. First, I told you about the rupee debit card and credit card. Second, I told you about the mobility card. Third, I told you about the USSD 99. And fourth, I told you about the Aadhaar enabled payment system. Now, this fifth system is the National Financial Switch. Ye National Financial Switch hai. So, this is nothing but the shared automated टेलर मशीन. ये शेयर्ड ऑटोमेटेड टेलर मशीन है. ठीक है, सो हियर दिस इज द नेटवर्क बेसिकली. ठीक है, सो इट इज कनेक्टिंग द एटीएम्स ऑफ वेरियस बैंक, जो बहुत सारे बैंक हैं आपस में उनकी एटीएम को कनेक्ट कर रहा है. ठीक है, सो दिस इज द बेसिकली काइंड ऑफ मीडिएटर विच इज कनेक्टिंग द एटीएम्स ऑफ ऑल द बैंक्स इन इंडिया. ठीक है, so this is national financial switch. Next, the next term is Bharat QR code. ठीक है, so what is Bharat QR code? First of all, what is the meaning of QR? QR means quick response. QR का मतलब होता है quick response. So you can see this code, ये code होता है, this is the QR code which has been developed by the NPCI in collaboration with the MasterCard and Visa for ease of payment and interoperability. ठीक है, interoperability के लिए और ease of payment के लिए. So this kind of system is capped by the merchant. कोई भी merchant होता है, अगर उसको payment receive करनी है, that merchant will be having this kind of paper or this kind of print with himself. And you can go to that person, you can pay through this QR code. So let us see how this works and what are the features. Hum kis tarah se iske features ko dekhte hain, let us see. So Bharat QR is a person to merchant mobile payment solution. You can make the payment from your mobile. So a person can make the payment to the merchant. Theek hai? This solution is mutually derived among the NPCI, Visa and MasterCard payment network. ठीक है, सो इट इज अ म्यूचुअल ड्राइव. इट दैट मींस
the Visa card, MasterCard, and NPCI Rupee card. All three cards are useful in this Bharat QR code. If you are having any of these three cards, agar aapke paas mein koi sa bhi card hai, you can make the payment through this Bharat QR code, right? So once the Bharat QR code are deployed on the merchant locations, the user can pay the utility bills using the Bharat QR code enabled mobile banking app, right? So let us see how this system works. Ye system kis tarah se work karta hai, let us see, right? So in this case, what will happen from the point of view of customer ke point of view se, the customer will download the mobile app, right? So consider you are the customer. Yes, samajh ke chalo ki aap customer ho, and then listen to this point. Tab is point ko suno aap, then you will be able to understand this point very very clearly. Suppose you are the customer, you download the mobile app. Aap mobile app download karte ho Bharat QR code ki. You link your card details to the app. So you will fill up your card details. That card can be a Rupee card, Visa card, or MasterCard, right? So that once that card is linked, uske baad kya hota hai? You go to the merchant location, right? You go to the merchant location and you enter the purchase amount after scanning the QR code. Once that is done, aap amount usme dal dete ho. For example, you entered 5000 rupees, right? Now you enter the OTP. Once you enter the OTP, your payment is done and merchant directly receives the amount in his bank account. So merchant directly receives the amount in the bank account. The payment is done. So this is the meaning of, this is the mechanism of Bharat QR code. So you install the any bank's application which supports the QR code. तो ये कोई बैंक की एप्लीकेशन होती है, दैट मींस यू शुड हैव द अकाउंट इन द इन दैट पर्टिकुलर बैंक, तभी ये काम करेगा, ठीक है? सो यू कैन यूज फॉर मेकिंग द कैब पेमेंट, ग्रोसरी पेमेंट, पेट्रोल डीजल पेमेंट, रेस्टोरेंट बिल, सुपरमार्केट, होम डिलीवरी. सो इफ दे हैव द भारत क्यूआर कोड एंड यू हैव द एप्लीकेशन विच इज लिंक टू द कार्ड, देन यू कैन मेक द पेमेंट from your card without like swiping your card. Aapko physical card ki koi zarurat nahi hai, right? So you can see what is the advantages. There is no requirement of physical card. Aapko apne jeb mein card rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai, theek hai? So now even having the card is not safe, right? Even having the card is not safe. I have heard many times ki like a gang of people will intimidate you, will take you to the ATM and will withdraw your cash. आपके cash को withdraw कर लेगा, ठीक है? तो ऐसा भी होता है. Even having the card is not safe. So to avoid having the physical card, you can use this Bharat QR code, ठीक है? तो इसमें से बहुत सारी चीजें हैं जो आप practically you can try. If you have the card, after this class you should try all these things so that things become more clear. जिससे कि आपको चीजें और क्लियर हो जाए. ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर वेरी वेरी इजी, वेरी वेरी यूजर फ्रेंडली एंड प्रैक्टिकल. यू कैन यूज इन ऑन डे टू डे बेसिस, ठीक है? चलिए, नाउ सेफ एंड सिक्योर पेमेंट, नो फियर ऑफ लूजिंग द कैश, वन स्टेप वेरिफिकेशन, सिर्फ एक सिंगल स्टेप से पेमेंट हो जाती है, नो वरीज ऑफ कैरिंग द चेंज एंड ऑल यू नीड इज द स्मार्टफोन. So unlike USSD, in case of Bharat QR code, you require the smartphone. So USSD 99 में आपको smartphone की जरूरत नहीं है, but here you require the mobile phone. ठीक है, smartphone basically. So Qoman QR is accepted across all the cards. Master, Visa, Rupee, even American Express, ठीक है? Leading banks ready to deploy Bharat QR code. So if you have the application of any of these banks, Axis, Bank of Baroda, almost every bank, you can use this Bharat QR code there. This is the world's, please take care, world ka, not only India. First,
interoperable QR code. Why we are seeing interoperable? Because you can use any card and you can make the payment from any bank account. So this is seamless integration. ये एक seamless integration provide करता है, ठीक है? So you can see once the Bharat QR code are deployed on the merchant location, user can pay the utility bill using the BQR enabled mobile banking app without sharing any user credential to the merchant, ठीक है? So what happens if you are carrying the card? अगर आपके पास में card carry कर रहे हो, ठीक है? And you swipe the card and you enter the pin. Many a time what happens if merchant want to misuse your credential, he can use. So many, this happened with me, myself. One fine day, I was on the petrol pump and I was paying for the petrol in my car. So maine apna credit card diya and that person said that your credit card is not working, please pay the cash. I took back my credit card and I paid the cash. After 2 days, the double payment go deducted from my account. Double payment mere account se deduct ho gayi. So what happens in many cases, some person from the side of merchant, for example, from the side of petrol seller, jo petrol pump ka owner hota hai, unki taraf se, some people might use user credential, like your card number, your PIN. So they have some mechanism, some technology through which they retain your credential when you are paying the payment through the credit card or debit card. Okay. So in this Bharat QR code, you are not supposed to share any credential. So this is very, very safe. Bharat QR code bahut zyada safe hai. Okay. So you can see world's first standardized QR code payment solution. Government introduces new scan and pay. Just scan karo aur pay karo. Single app that allows cross platform payment. Anybody with a smartphone to zarur chahiye isme, can generate the QR code and scan it to make the payment. It is jointly developed by NPCI, MasterCard and Visa. NPCI, MasterCard aur Visa ne isko jointly implement. The next system is National Electronic Toll Collection. ठीक है? Next system क्या नाम क्या है? National Electronic Toll Collection. So here I will be taking the break of 2 minutes. मैं 2 minutes का break लेता हूँ. ठीक है? आप भी ले लीजिए. You take a break of 2 minutes because it's been more than 1 hour. I have been discussing.
Okay, so welcome back. I will be answering your queries
after some time. Let us continue the discussion of the topics. पहले हम टॉपिक डिस्कस कर लेते हैं. नेशनल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक टोल कलेक्शन, राइट? सो यू वुड हैव हर्ड दिस टर्म फास्टैग. आप लोगों ने नाम सुना होगा. सो दोज ऑफ यू हु ट्रेवल थ्रू द कार एंड पे द टोल चार्जेस, दे मस्ट नो अबाउट दिस फास्टैग, राइट? सो दिस फास्टैग इज बेसिकली इलेक्ट्रॉनिक टोलिंग पेमेंट सिस्टम. यू कैन पे द टोल अमाउंट इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली फ्रॉम योर अकाउंट. आप अपने अकाउंट से इलेक्ट्रॉनिक टोल पेमेंट कर सकते हो. फॉर दैट यू हैव टू हैज फास्टैग ऑन योर व्हीकल. आपको अपने व्हीकल पर फास्टैग रखना होगा, राइट? सो हाउ दिस मैकेनिज्म वर्क्स. सो यू हैव द कार. आपके पास में कार है. ऑन दिस कार देर इज द फास्टैग. ऑन दिस कार देर इज दिस फास्टैग. सो द फास्टैग इज डिप्लॉयड ऑन द कार, राइट? यू हैव परचेस्ड दिस फास्टैग फ्रॉम सम बैंक, फॉर एग्जाम्पल HDFC, SBI और समवेयर, ठीक है? सो व्हेन यू पास ऑन विद द टोल प्लाजा सिस्टम, जब आप टोल प्लाजा से पास ऑन करते हो, ठीक है? व्हेन यू पास ऑन टू द टोल प्लाजा सिस्टम, द डिटेल्स आर सेंट टू द एक्वायरर बैंक. देयर इज सम बैंक हु इज इन्वॉल्व्ड इन द इन्वॉल्व्ड विद द टोल प्लाजा सिस्टम. जो टोल प्लाजा सिस्टम का खुद का बैंक है उसको हम बोलते हैं एक्वायरर बैंक. So the information about this payment. So suppose you pass to the toll. आप किसी भी toll से pass on करते हो. There is some RFID mechanism which captures the details of your card. जो आपके card की details को capture करता है, ठीक है? जो आपकी card की details को capture करता है, ठीक है? And those details are verified with your issuer bank, that whether you have balance in your account or not, everything is verified from the issuer bank. If your bank is clear, validates the transaction, then the settlement is done with the help of settlement bank, and the money is transferred from issuer bank to the acquirer bank. ठीक है? तो सपोज आपका HDFC बैंक है और इनका पंजाब नेशनल बैंक है. सो द मनी विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड फ्रॉम योर अकाउंट टू द टोल प्लाजा अकाउंट. सो दिस इज हाउ दिस नेशनल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक टोल कलेक्शन वर्क्स, ठीक है? सो लेट अस सी सम फीचर्स ऑफ द NETC. लेट अस सी द इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर्स ऑफ द NETC. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज द टाइप ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन? सो दिस टाइप ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन इज ऑफलाइन. ये ऑफलाइन ट्रांजेक्शन है बट very near to the real time, because here the signals are captured on the toll plaza immediately, and within the 10 minute the transaction is completed. ठीक है? So this is offline but very near to the real time transaction processing. There is interoperability. Interoperability why? Because you can use the card which has been issued by many banks. So आपका बैंक HDFC हो सकता है, SBI हो सकता है. There are many other banks which are issuing the card. So there can be multiple issuers and the multiple acquirers. That is, the tag issued by any member bank is accepted at all toll plaza under NETS program acquired by any member bank in a safe and secured manner. ठीक है? तो किसी भी बैंक ने इश्यू किया हुआ हो और किसी भी बैंक ने एक्वायर किया हुआ हो, यानी कि the vehicle owner can have the card of any bank, and the toll plaza can have the system of this payment with any bank, but all the system will be interoperable. आपने किस बैंक से ये सिस्टम लिया है, और आपका जो टोल प्लाजा है उसका किस बैंक से सिस्टम है, it does not matter. This NETC will make it possible
to transfer the money across the bank. Across the bank. That is why this is National Electronic Toll Collection System. That is why this is interoperable. Ye aapka interoperable hai. The flexibility to choose underlying payment instruments. ठीक है, so you can use, you can link this fast tag. आप इस fast tag को link कर सकते हो with your existing saving account, your current account, or to a prepaid account. Basis the offering from issuer member bank. ठीक है, so suppose you have the car. आपके पास में car है. You want to have some fast tag on your card. So you can go to your bank, your own bank, जहाँ पर आपका account है. आप उनसे ले सकते हो card को. And in the future, if you have to pay some toll payment on your vehicle, the amount will be deducted from your account directly. ठीक है? तो one option is this, that you link your fast tag with your existing saving account, current account, or some prepaid account. Right? Prepaid account means even if you don't have the account with any bank. For example, I don't have the account with the Punjab National Bank, but still I can go to the Punjab National Bank and I can open one prepaid account. I can deposit 1000 rupees and I can buy the fast tag, and this toll payment will be deducted from my prepaid account of 1000 rupees. And once this becomes zero, I can again refill this amount. जब ये जीरो हो जाएगा तो मैं फिर से इसको रिफिल कर सकता हूं. ठीक है, सो आई कैन यूज द माय एग्जिस्टिंग सेविंग अकाउंट, करंट अकाउंट, और आई कैन यूज द प्रीपेड अकाउंट. इन केस ऑफ प्रीपेड अकाउंट, आई एम नॉट सपोज टू हैव एनी प्रायर रिलेशनशिप विद द इश्यूअर बैंक. आई एम नॉट सपोज टू हैव एनी सेविंग अकाउंट, करंट अकाउंट. आई एम नॉट सपोज टू हैव एनी अकाउंट विद द बैंक. आई कैन जस्ट गो एंड बाय द प्रीपेड कार्ड सिस्टम. मैं सिर्फ प्रीपेड फास्टैग कार्ड बाय कर सकता हूँ. सो जस्ट लाइक इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ योर सिम कार्ड. जो मोबाइल का सिम कार्ड होता है ना, आप किसी भी कंपनी के पास में जाओ, अपनी केवाईसी डिटेल दो, एंड बेस्ड अपॉन दैट केवाईसी डिटेल यू विल गेट द सिम कार्ड एंड यू स्टार्ट यूटिलाइजिंग दैट सिम कार्ड. इट इज प्रीपेड कार्ड. योर बैलेंस विल कम जीरो, यू अगेन गो एंड रिफिल. सिमिलरली इन केस ऑफ फास्टैग, यू कैन गो टू एनी बैंक विच इज इश्यूइंग दिस, विच इज पार्ट ऑफ द channel which is issuing these fast tag, and you can buy the prepaid card even if you don't have the account, right? And if you have the account, you can interlink with the account so that you are not supposed to refill again and again. Aapko refill karne ki zarurat na pade. Aapka jo payment hai wo aapke automatically account se hota rahe. Theek hai? Who can issue the tag? The fast tag can be issued by the member banks authorized for the NETC program. So there is a list of banks who are authorized. Only they can issue, right? This is a completely cashless payment, right? So while your vehicle is in motion, the payment is being made at the toll plaza immediately. It saves the time and fuel because you are not supposed to stop, pay in cash, etc. You can recharge the FASTag account online, and this recharge can happen through various modes. You can recharge with the help of UPI, credit card, debit card, NEFT, RTGS, net banking. So can you see the kind of interoperability? Like lot of options are available. Aap bahut sare tarike se aap isko online recharge kara sakte ho. Theek hai? And as of now, if you pay the amount of your toll with the FASTag, then there is a cashback scheme where you will be getting the cashback of 2.5%. So this cashback scheme is also available. Okay. So these are the features of NETS. Now what is the FASTag? FASTag kya hota hai? Okay. So FASTag is a electronic toll collection system which is operated by the National Highway Authority of India. ठीक है, so this mechanism of NETC is provided by the NPCI. ठीक है, this operation is like this NETC system where all the banks are linked with each other, right? There is this complete system of payment authorization, payment transfer, that is done by the NPCI. But definitely, this FASTag is under the domain of the NHAI only, because all the toll plazas are under the NHAI. Okay. So NETC and FASTag, it employs radio frequency identification technology. Radio frequency hota hai, theek hai? It is using the radio frequency for making the toll payment directly from the prepaid or saving account linked to the or directly toll owner. FASTags are prepaid chargeable tags for toll collection and is affixed on the windscreen of the screen. The validity of the FASTag is 5 years after the initial purchase. So this is important. And if you have two vehicle, then two separate FASTag will be required for each vehicle, right? So agar aapke paas mein do vehicle hai, aapko alag alag FASTag aapko use karna hoga, right? Even if you are owning both the vehicles. Apart from that, we have Beam, which is a mobile app working in the UPI mode. There is UPI system, which is real time interbank payment system for sending or receiving the payment. And then there is Bharat Bill Payment System. So all of these things we will discuss in today's session only. Okay. Okay, great. So now you can see Bharat Bill Payment System. Okay. So meanwhile, let me answer your queries. Aapke kuch queries aayi hui hain. So Devanshi has asked. So if you have any query, please type in the chat box so that I can answer your queries. Devanshi has asked the question. Sir, Bharat QR code is similar to Paytm. It is like, if you see the operation, it is similar to Paytm, but it is much better than Paytm in many ways, because in case of Bharat QR code, the amount is deducted directly from your bank account. You are not supposed to have the money in your wallet. Koi wallet nahi hai. Bharat QR code mein koi wallet nahi hai. You just have the application of the bank, go to the merchant, scan, enter the PIN, and payment is done. In case of Paytm, you are supposed to have the amount in your Paytm wallet. Aapko Paytm wallet mein amount rakhne ki zarurat hai. Theek hai? In case of Paytm, there can be some upper limit. Koi upper limit ho sakti hai. But in case of Bharat QR code, there is no limit. So Bharat QR code is much more interoperable, much more easy to use, much more secure, and almost everyone can accept Bharat QR code payment. Theek hai? But in case of Paytm, only that person who is having the Paytm QR code with his in his shop, only that person can be using the system of Paytm. Theek hai? Abhi hum assume kar rahe hain ki UPI nahi hai. In case of UPI, this Paytm is also equally valid. Theek hai? Then sir, what is the difference between the MasterCard and MasterCard? So just like we have Visa and Master, similarly, this third company is available, which is MasterCard. Okay. MasterCard and Visa card are very, very famous. MasterCard is not that much famous, but MasterCard is just another company. Okay. It is just another company. Devanshi, if there is some code for everyone, same gate for everyone, then it can threat the security issues. Any person can. Yes. So you should have the same, you should not have the same code for everyone. Okay. Same code for everyone, then it can threat the security issues. Anyone can access the other phone and make the transaction. Same code for receipt of the payment, not for making the payment. Okay. Preet is saying, if there is so much threat to card system and digital payment, should we go back to the cash in hand system? Okay. So my friend, everyone, every new technology has some pros and cons. So if you are using the Facebook, it has many advantages. You can connect to your friends. You can see what is happening in their life. Aapko ye pata chalta rahega ki unke life mein kya ho raha hai. But there is privacy issue. Your images, your information, your whereabouts, everything can be shared. So everything has pros and cons. It depends upon us. How do we use the available technology? Similarly, these card system, this online payment, they can pose threat. Does not mean that we should not use this system. We should use this system with care. Okay. Devanshi is saying, are not digital payment inconvenient if there is no proper internet connection? Yes, definitely. If internet connection is not proper, they are not easy, definitely. Subhajit is saying payment, Paytm is now also UPI based. Yes, it is also UPI based, but still Bharat QR code is much more acceptable because Paytm is a private company, right? Chaliye. Bharat Bill Payment System and National Payment Corporation of India. ठीक है? So this BBPS, Bharat Bill Payment System, is also one of the product of the NPCI only. ठीक है? So RBI has expanded the scope and coverage of Bharat Bill Payment System to include all categories of billers. All categories of billers, right? So name itself says bill payment system. That means you can pay your bills. किस तरह के बिल हो सकते हैं? आपका इलेक्ट्रिसिटी का बिल हो सकता है, आपका गैस का बिल हो सकता है, वाटर का बिल हो सकता है, जो आपका मंथली बेस पर आता है, कोई भी बिल जो आपका मंथली और वी कैन से रिकरिंग बेस पर आता है, ठीक है, मंथली और रिकरिंग बिल आता है, all those bill can be paid with the help of Bharat Bill Payment System. ठीक है, so all the categories of bill which are recurring, monthly or bi-monthly, किसी भी तरह के हों, except the prepaid recharge. So we are not talking about the prepaid, we are talking about the postpaid. And this is voluntary. So if you want to utilize the system, you can utilize. If you don't want to utilize, don't utilize. It is voluntary. It is not mandatory. At present, it is available only for the five segment. अभी तक ये सिर्फ five segment में available थी. DTH, electricity, gas, water, telecom. But now it has been expanded to all categories of bill. So earlier it was available only for five categories of bill. Now it is available for all kind of bills. ठीक है. So what is BBPS? BBPS, Bill Payment System, is a RBI conceptualized system driven by NPCI. So technology is by the NPCI, concept is from the side of RBI. ठीक है? This is anytime, anywhere bill payment, one stop payment platform for all the bills, interoperable, accessible. Here the payment can be done with the help of cash, check, electronic mode. Bill aggregator and the banks who will function as operating unit will carry out these transactions for the customer. ठीक है? Now, so the questions which I asked from you, जो मैंने आपसे सवाल पूछे थे, let us see the answer to these questions. So the answer to this question is option D, 2 and 3. Option 1 is wrong because here it is not the Bank Board Bureau, it is the Indian Banks Association, right? Statement 2 is correct. It is not profit company only. Statement 3 is also correct because it has developed the NETC program also for making the e-toll payment. RuPay card, in case of RuPay card, I already told you the answer. It is both debit and credit card. It is the product of the NPCI. And insurance facilities available for all type of the debit card. Please take care. Debit card. So here the answer is option B, 1 and 3 only. Fastag, in case of Fastag, it is issued separately for each owner. The period is 4 year, not 4 years, 5 year. It is 5 years. NPCI does not issue Fastag. This is true. NPCI do not issue the Fastag. Okay. NPCI has developed NETC system. So there are member banks who issue. NPCI, so who issue this Fastag, but not the NPCI. NPCI do not issue the Fastag. NPCI has made this system of NETC. ठीक है, लेकिन ये card issue नहीं करता. ठीक है, so statement is correct. So answer is option C, both 1 and 3. Now please give the answer to this question.
So please give the answer in the chat box. Everyone, please give the answer. Tomorrow again we have the class at 10 a.m. So tomorrow we will discuss about various issues, the banking system, merger of banks, nationalization of banks, small finance bank, payment bank, deposit insurance. So all these things we will discuss tomorrow. Most probably this money and banking chapter should be complete by tomorrow. ठीक है? कोशिश करेंगे कि money and banking chapter कल complete हो जाए. We already had 6-7 sessions. And each and every topic is important in the money and banking. That is why I did not compromise. मैंने कोई compromise नहीं किया. ठीक है? The next chapter we will start is public finance. After that we will start is taxation. Then external sector. ठीक है? So we will cover all the concept, MCQs, current affairs, everything. So tomorrow we will have money and banking. And on Tuesday, probably I will be discussing the GS2 and GS3 mains 2019 papers. ठीक है? So I will try to discuss the previous year questions also. Let me see. Not yet final, but I am thinking like that. Okay, great. So I can see most of you are giving the answer. Very, very good. Wonderful. So, both easy question. Nothing great. So, it is BHIM 2.0. Definitely, it will be the improved version of the previous BHIM application. Very, very easy. Okay. Next question. Please give the answer. Please give the answer. Everyone, please give the answer. Very good. I can see most of you are giving the right answer. Very good. Answer to this question is option A, both 1 and 2. Right? So both the statements are correct. Dono statement correct hai aapki. Theek hai? So let us see what is this UPI. UPI kya hai? So it is a system which powers multiple bank account into a single mobile application. आपके पास में एक सिंगल मोबाइल एप्लीकेशन है, यू कैन लिंक योर मल्टीपल बैंक अकाउंट. सो फॉर एग्जांपल, यू हैव द अकाउंट इन स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया, यू हैव द बैंक अकाउंट इन आईसीआईसीआई बैंक, एचडीएफसी बैंक, पंजाब नेशनल बैंक, राइट? सो यू कैन लिंक ऑल दीज 3-4 बैंक्स विद योर मोबाइल ऐप, विद द यूपीआई ऐप, एंड यू कैन यूज दिस यूपीआई ऐप फॉर inquiring about the balance, for making the payment, for receiving the payment. All these things features are available. So it has merged several banking features, seamless fund routing and merchant payment into one hood. It caters to the peer-to-peer collect request, which can be scheduled and paid as per the requirement and convenience. So even you can make the collect request, you can generate your collect request and someone else can use that request as the payment mechanism to you. Each bank provides own UPI app. So you can have any bank account. In each of the bank account, you have the UPI app. It allows a customer to pay directly from the bank account to the different merchant, both online and offline, without the hassle of typing credit card details, IFSC or net banking wallet password. ठीक है? तो आप online और offline दोनों ही transaction इसमें कर सकते हो. ठीक है? You have the app and you are not supposed to have any card.
you are not supposed to have any IFSC code. You are not supposed to have any net banking wallet password, right? You should have only app, and with the help of the app, you can make the payment. Okay. It is regulated by RBI and built over the IMPS. Regulation RBI karta hai, and it has been built over the technology of the IMPS. What is Bheem? So Bheem is UPI based payment interface. Bharat interface for money. It is developed by the NPCI for real time transfer. Does not hold the money like other wallets. So this is very, very important. And the money can be sent to the non-UPI linked account. Agar kisi ke account UPI linked nahi hai, and if you have IFSC code and account number, you can send the money from your Bheem app to that person, right? So you can see how this UPI works. You download the UPI app from the Play Store. You install it on your phone. You set up the login. You create the virtual address. For example, Rahul@ICICI. This can be my virtual address, right? So if you have this virtual address, you can make the payment to me. Okay? I can share this virtual address to you and you can make the payment. I can address my bank details. I can use more than one bank. I can set my mobile PIN, which will be used for making the payment. And I can start using the API. So what are the advantages? Real-time settlement of fund. No need to remember or share any account detail. So if you have the UPI ID of some other person, then you can make the payment from your account. Send the money using the virtual ID. Virtual ID aapko chahiye. You are not supposed to have any IFSC code, account number. You just need is UPI ID. Add multiple bank account in the same application. आप सेम एप्लीकेशन में बहुत सारे अकाउंट को ऐड कर सकते हो, राइट? सो ऑल दीज बैंक्स आर प्रोवाइडिंग, यू कैन डाउनलोड एंड इंस्टॉल, यू कैन क्रिएट द ऐप लॉगिन वर्चुअल एड्रेस एट द बैंक एमपिन, स्टार्ट ट्रांसफरिंग फंड थ्रू यू वर्चुअल आईडी, राइट? और यू कैन ट्रांसफर द फंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ अकाउंट प्लस आईएफएससी, मोबाइल नंबर प्लस एमएमआईडी और आधार कार्ड. सो ऑल दीज फोर मोड्स, अगर आपके पास में वर्चुअल आईडी है, अकाउंट नंबर प्लस आईएफएससी है, मोबाइल नंबर प्लस एमएमआईडी है और आधार कार्ड है, इफ यू हैव एनी ऑफ फोर दीज थिंग्स, देन यू कैन मेक द पेमेंट. तब आप पेमेंट कर सकते हो. सो वेंकटेश, योर आंसर इज गिवन थ्रू यूपीआई, आधार नंबर ट्रांसफर इज अवेलेबल. यस. नाउ दिस Bheem हैज बीन इंप्रूव्ड. दिस इज इन न्यूज, ये न्यूज में है. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस ओनली we are discussing this topic, right? So there are some new functions. For example, donation gateway, hai na, aap donate kar sakte ho. Increased transaction limit for high value transactions, linking multiple bank account, offers from merchant, option for applying the IPO. What is IPO? Initial public offering. So if some new company is issuing the share, then you can invest in the share of that company. You can even gift the money. Okay? So if you want to gift something to your friend, your parents, or even to me, agar aap mujhe bhi gift karna chahte ho, you can gift to me. Okay? It also supports three additional languages. So this is a new feature. Three languages: Konkani, Bhojpuri, Haryanvi, over the existing 13. So just remember these three languages: Konkani, Bhojpuri, Haryanvi. These three languages have been added. Okay?